If a big enough comet hits the Earth, we all die. But what happens if it hits the Sun? Hey guys, Amy with you, getting nerdy about space impacts on D News today. Comets, sometimes referred to as dirty snowballs, are giant blocks of ice and rock way out in the Oort cloud, the distant region home to icy planetesimals left over from our solar system's formation. They trace elliptical orbits around the sun. As they approach, the heat and force of the solar wind melts some of the ice, turning it into a gorgeous gaseous tail that astronomers love. But some comets aren't so lucky and whip really close to our star. These are called Sungrazers, and they can pass within a few thousand miles of the sun's surface. But the sun isn't exactly solid. It's a mass of incredibly hot gas, mainly hydrogen. The outermost layer is called the solar corona, where temperatures can be millions of degrees Kelvin. So what happens when a dirty snowball gets too close to something that big and that hot? Well, it's not great for the snowball. We know the sun has a strong gravitational environment, so one potential death factor for comets is the sun's Roche limit. This is the imaginary line around the sun, where if a body gets any closer, it could be ripped apart by tidal forces. But not always. Survival depends on that body. If the comet doesn't have a firm enough central mass, it will be ripped apart by the sun's gravitational forces. Think pulling apart cotton candy. But if the comet is so frozen solid, it can pass inside the Roche limit and survive. It would be like trying to pull apart a jawbreaker. It can't happen. Counterintuitive as it might be, it's not the corona that poses the biggest threat to comets. It's not dense enough to transfer enough heat. It's actually solar radiation, the electromagnetic energy emitted by the sun, that's the danger. This is the same radiation that causes sunburns, so it's super intense up close and powerful enough to sublimate ice in comets and crack apart rocks. If the ice melts and the rock cracks, this can weaken the comet's overall structure, making it less likely to survive its encounter with the sun. But some comets, even Sungrazers, still survive. Comet Lovejoy survived its close encounter with the sun in December of 2011. Astronomers observed the comet after it passed through the solar corona. It looked like its nucleus, the comet's head if you will, had vanished and the tail was longer and brighter. Researchers concluded that the coronal heat vaporized the ice and cracked away the rocky body, which dissipated into the long, bright tail. So it was worse for the wear, but alive. Comet Ison had a similar success story in 2013. Astronomers suspect it was broken apart, but the parts continued traveling together and eventually bunched up to look brighter than it did before its encounter with the sun. But what if a comet actually hits the sun? Well, again, it's not solid, but that can still happen. A big enough comet pulled into the sun would be accelerated to more than 370 miles per second, at which point drag from the sun's atmosphere would flatten the comet with enough force that it would explode in an airburst, releasing ultraviolet radiation and X-rays. It could be as powerful as a magnetic flare or coronal mass ejection, but in a smaller area, sparking sunquakes. These are all effects astronomers can see with modern instruments, but they're not going to do any damage to us here on Earth. Isn't space just awesome? And so many things going smashy-smashy, and not just comets. NASA used to smash spent spacecraft into the moon for science. I tell you why over on my own channel, Vintage Space. So what happened to this kind of weird, awkwardly legless looking bit of lunar module after its mission was over? The lunar module's consumables were done by the time the lunar mission was over, and so there was no need and no reason to bring this spacecraft back to Earth. But regardless of what else is happening in space, the sun always looks awesome. I tell you why in this video right here. So if someone were to ask you what color the sun is, you'd probably say yellow, right? Or maybe orange or pink if you're seeing it at sunrise or sunset. Well, the sun looks yellow because of our atmosphere. If you could look at the sun in space, it would be a white ball. But it doesn't look like a boring old white ball in these pictures from SDO, you say. Astronomers out there, have you guys ever managed to see a comet hit the sun? I'm super curious, so let us know in the comments below. And don't forget to like this video and subscribe so you never miss an episode of D News.